Hello friends, welcome to our second lecture of series Mobile Networks Architecture and Evolution. In our first lecture, we had a quick review of the different generations of mobile networks and what actually are the differences between them. So let's have a quick recap. We earlier saw that what was the difference between 2G and 1G network. The 2G and 1G networks, the main difference is that the 2G network is digital while the 1G network was analog, and there was much less capacity in the 1G network. The 2G network also supported the data connectivity as well, but of much less speed. The 3G network then came to support much better voice quality as well as the higher data rates. Then came the 4G or the LTE networks. But the main focus in case of 4G and LTE networks was the data connectivity. It did not have any dedicated solution for voice, but of course the voice had to be supported as a basic solution through some other means. Then came the 5G technology, 5G networks, which not in addition to services from human, it also considered the machine communication as well, along with other aspects of reliability, the volume rates, and the connectivity throughput. We also saw that in case of evolution to 3G, 4G, and 5G, what different technologies contributed to higher data connectivity. Like in case of 2G, we had GPRS Edge. In case of 3G, we saw HSPA and HSPA Plus, and so on. So today we will be having a look into the mobile networks architecture evolution from a slightly different perspective. That all these technologies which we just saw, they are basically converging to 4G. We can see over here that basically there are three streams going towards 4G. This first stream, this second stream, and this third stream. So the first stream was basically the GSM. The GSM supported by GPRS Edge, and then it is going towards LTE. Then the GSM basically turned into 3G as we saw earlier, which was called basically WCDMA. The release for that was basically called R99. R99 was basically having specifications for both core network and access network as well. And then R5, R6, and R7 was basically meant for higher data rate connectivity. And then this second stream is basically for CDMA standards. This is mainly used in North America. But again, this standard has again evolved towards 4G right now. The third stream is basically belongs to 802 standards. These standards are basically for Wi-Fi. So we can see over here that over the time, these standards are again converging to 4G. And also it would be interesting for you to have a look that how GSM and CDMA, they correspond to 2G, and then came the GPRS, which is basically termed as 2.5G, and then came the Edge with the better data rate, which is basically termed the 2.75G. And when the WCDMA R99 specifications came and was deployed, followed by the CDMA 2000, then this is basically termed as the 3G networks. And then when the high data rates were deployed in the 3G networks, then it eventually transformed to 3.5G networks. And similarly, followed by even more higher data rates in the uplink direction, this is basically called the 3.75 generation. And 3.9, basically the LTE also falls into the 3.9 generation, and later on it was fully transformed into the 4G technology. So this view will give you a very good standard that how multiple standards eventually converged, and basically this is again travel to from the TDM to all IP networks. In the latest technologies, our most reliance and more dependency is on the IP networks, and TDM networks are eventually being phased out. I hope this will give you a better understanding of the network's evolution in terms of technologies and how they basically converge to the higher technologies. Now let's have a look from another perspective that we have been discussing. So in terms of practical networks, how they are being deployed. In our current lecture, we will be just having a brief look of the different entities that are being deployed in the practical networks. Mainly, networks are divided in three parts: the core network, the access network, and the applications, different applications. So in this case, this part basically refers to the core network, which is divided into the circuit switched core and the packet switched core. And this is basically the access network from where the wireless part belongs to. So in case of circuit switched core, the main controlling entity is called the MSC server, while the payload is being handled by the media gateway. Same goes with the PS core as well, where the control node is the SGSN, while the payload is being handled towards the other network is the GGSN. This is true for 2G and 3G, while in case of 4G network, the control node is called the MME, the mobility management entity, while the payload is being handled by the SGW, the serving gateway. So, like, if we have a quick look into the network interfaces are very important in terms of understanding the network. So let's restrict this video to 2G networks as well. So if we have a look into the interface between the MSC server and the BSC, which is the base station controller with which the BTS are connected, which we can see in our vicinity, in our area, lot of towers. These towers in case of GSM are basically called the BTS. So the interface between the BTS and the BSC is called the ABIS interface. You need to remember this because this is very important, because the signaling between the interfaces is dependent on the interfaces, and we need to identify the protocol stack as well. Similarly, the interface between the BSC and the MSC server is called the A interface. In case of data connectivity, the interface between the BSC and the SGSN is called GB interface. If I talk of MSC server and media gateway, the interface between them is called the MC interface or the MEGACO interface. Similarly, the interfaces between the two MSC servers is called the NC interface, and the interface between the two media gateways is basically the NB interface. These interfaces are of fundamental importance. You need to remember them. And also based on this, we will be going into the protocol stack as well, that how different interfaces communicate with each other and on which layer they communicate with each other, which messages they exchange with each other. So like if I talk about 3G network as well, then in case of 3G network, the BTS are basically called the node Bs. The interface between the node B and its controller, the radio network controller, is called the IUB interface. The interface between the RNC and the MSC is called the IUCS interface, while the interface between the RNC and the PS core is called the IUPS interface. The interface between the two RNCs is called the IUR interface. So I think this is enough for today, and in the later video we will be having a look into the other interfaces as well for the evolved packet core, and we will extend our discussion to other application parts as well. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned. I hope this video will add to your knowledge. Thank you.